नमस्ते, मायसेल्फ MS बासरगांव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड साइंसेस, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस गामा फंक्शन पार्ट टू, लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई गामा फंक्शन टू इवेलुएट डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल्स। नाउ pause the video for a while and evaluate integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x cube dx. I hope you have completed. So in the first session we have discussed about the gamma function. Now here the given integral is integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x cube dx. Now to express this in terms of gamma function, that is integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x into x raised to n minus 1 dx, here the proper substitution is x cube is equal to t. Taking cube root on both sides, we get x equal to t raised to 1 by 3, that is dx is equal to 1 by 3 t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt. Now here accordingly you have to change the limit. When x is equal to 0, we get t equal to 0, and when x tends to infinity, t tends to infinity. Therefore, integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus x cube dx is equal to integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus t, and the value of dx is 1 by 3 t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt, which is equal to 1 by 3 integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus t into t raised to minus 2 by 3 dt, which is equal to, we can write 1 by 3 gamma of 1 by 3 here. Comparing with the definition of gamma function, n minus 1 is equal to minus 2 by 3. Therefore, n is equal to 1 minus 2 by 3, that is what, 1 by 3. Therefore, the value of the given integral is 1 by 3 into gamma of 1 by 3. Now, in this one, again, we'll see the different types of example to be expressed in terms of gamma function. Now, here, take the example, evaluate integration from 0 to 1 x cube log of 1 by x raised to the power 4 dx. Now here the given integral involves logarithm function. Therefore, first of all, we will simplify here. Therefore, we can write integration from 0 to 1 x cube log of 1 by x raised to 4 dx is equal to integration from 0 to 1 x cube into log of 1 by x raised to 4 can be written as 4 into log of 1 by x dx, since we know log of a raised to b as a b log a, which is equal to, we can write 4 into integration from 0 to 1 x cube log of 1 by x dx. Now we have to express this integrand in terms of e raised to minus t. For that, the suitable substitution is, let log of 1 by x is equal to t. That is, we can write 1 by x equal to e raised to t. Therefore, we can write x is equal to e raised to minus t. Therefore, dx is equal to minus e raised to minus t dt. Now, here, accordingly, we will change the limit. When x is equal to 0, if we put x equal to 0, then in this one, then t tends to infinity. And when x is equal to 1, that is, here log of 1 is 0, therefore t equal to 0. Therefore, the given integral can be written as integration from 0 to 1 x cube log of 1 by x raised to 4 dx is equal to 4 into, here lower limit is infinity and upper limit is 0, that is infinity to 0 e raised to minus 3t into t, and the value of dx is minus e raised to minus t dt, which is equal to, we can write 4 into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus 4t, that is e raised to minus 3t into e raised to minus t, that is e raised to minus 4t t dt. Here we are using the fundamental theorem of definite integral, that is integration from a to b f of x dx is equal to minus integration from b to a f of x dx. If you change the upper and lower limit, change in the sign of the integral. Now again, this function is not in terms of gamma function. Therefore, again, we have to make use of the substitution 4t equal to y, that is t equal to y by 4. Therefore, dt equal to dy by 4. 4. Again here we have to change the limits. When t equal to 0, we get y equal to 0, and when t tends to infinity, y tends to infinity. Therefore, the given integral can be written as 4 into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus y, y by 4 dy by 4, which is here 4 will get cancelled, taking 1 by 4 common outside, that is 1 by 4 integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus y into y dy, which is equal to 1 by 4 into gamma of 2, because here n minus 1 is 1, therefore n is 2, therefore we can write gamma of 2. Gamma of 2 can be written as 1 factorial by using n plus 1 equal to n factorial by 4, which is equal to 1 by 4. Now we'll see the next example. Evaluate the integral integration from 0 to infinity a raised to minus b x square dx. Now here base is a, we have to convert this to the base e, and here to express this integrand in terms of exponential function, we have to make use of substitution a raised to minus b x square equal to e raised to minus t. Taking logarithm on both sides, we get minus b x square log a equal to minus t log e, and simplifying we get b x square log of a equal to t, because log to the base e of e is 1. Now solving for x square, here we get x square equal to t by b log a, that is x equal to t raised to 1 by 2 divided by square root of b log a, and therefore dx is equal to 1 by square root of b log a into 1 by 2 t raised to minus half dt. Now accordingly we have to change the limit. When x is equal to 0, putting x equal to 0 here, we get t equal to 0, and when x tends to infinity, t tends to infinity. Therefore, the given integral integration from 0 to infinity a raised to minus b x square dx is equal to integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus t, and the value of dx is 1 by 2 root b log a into t raised to minus 1 by 2 dt. Now taking constant term outside, which is equal to 1 by 2 root b log a into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus t into t raised to minus half dt, which is equal to 1 by 2 root b log a gamma of 1 by 2, because here n minus 1 is minus 1 by 2, therefore n is 1 by 2, which is equal to root pi divided by 2 root b log a. This was the value of the given integral. Now we'll see one more example of different type. Evaluate integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 5 by 5 raised to x dx. Now here we have to convert this in terms of gamma function, and for that suitable substitution is here 5 raised to x is equal to e raised to t. Now here taking logarithm on both sides, we can write x log 5 is equal to t, because log of e is 1. Therefore dx is equal to 1 by log 5 dt. Now here again we have to change the limits. When x is equal to 0, putting x equal to 0 here, we get the value of t equal to 0, and when x tends to infinity, t tends to infinity. Now substituting the substitution and the limits in the given integral, that is integration from 0 to infinity x raised to 5 divided by 5 raised to x dx is equal to integration from 0 to infinity. Now here we have to substitute the value of x, that is t by log 5 raised to the power 5, and 5 raised to x, that is e raised to t, and the value of dx as 1 by log 5 dt. Now taking the constant term, that is 1 by log 5 raised to 5 and 1 by log 5, that you can take outside the integral, which is equal to 1 by log 5 raised to 6 into integration from 0 to infinity e raised to, taking e raised to the numerator, that we get e raised to minus t and t raised to 5 dt, which is equal to, we can write log 5 raised to 6 into gamma of 6, because here n minus 1 is 5, therefore n is 6, therefore the value of this we can write gamma of 6, and which is equal to, you can write value of gamma of 6 can be written as 5 factorial by using the property gamma of n plus 1 is equal to n factorial if n is positive integer. Therefore, you can write here the value of gamma of 6 as a 5 factorial divided by log 5 raised to 6. Here 5 factorial means 120, which is equal to 120 divided by log 5 raised to 6. References: Higher Engineering Mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal.